Good morning. Welcome back. Live pictures of the GWB to greet you on this Thursday morning. Yes, it is April Fool's Day, 49 degrees, and we are in for an absolutely beautiful day. We'll talk to John in just a moment. But first, have you ever looked at a celebrity on television or in a magazine and said, wow, she looks great. I thought she was much older than that.
Well, there's always one thing that gives away their true age. Dr. Max Gomez is here to tell us what it is and what you can do to rejuvenate.
Got any guesses?
Duh.
I know we've given it away already. Good morning, Maurice. Good morning, Kate. You know, plastic surgery can help with various body parts, face, bust, neck, tummy. Then exercise can keep the body toned and youthful. The rest you can cover with clothing, but look at a person's hands. They're always out there. It's kind of odd to cover them up if it's not freezing outside, and it's a dead giveaway of a person's real age. Now there's a simple way to turn back the hands of time.
Pet Christodoulou eats well, exercises, takes care of herself. You probably wouldn't guess this youthful woman is 63, unless you looked at her hands.
Well, my hands sort of lag behind everything. You know, they sort of don't look that fresh, and I thought that it would be nice just to freshen them up a little. Mm-hmm. You know, I have big veins, and they look haggard, I think.
They're the bane of aging women. Hands are always exposed to the sun and environment, and hands have very little fat under the skin.
As soon as they lose a little bit of their subcutaneous fat, bingo, you have a lot of bulging structures, the veins and tendons.
Which leads many people to become self-conscious.
I notice that I don't wear rings a lot, and I don't, like if I try on jewelry, sometimes I think, oh, better not to wear jewelry because it draws attention to your hands.
But now there's a way to rejuvenate hands quickly and simply. It uses Radiesse, a filler first developed to ease facial folds and wrinkles. It's made of
calcium hydroxylapatite, which is a natural component in bone. And it's non-allergenic, which means that the patients won't have an allergic reaction.
But in the hands, it's used a little differently. First, it's diluted with xylocaine to make it painless, and also so it will flow into the nooks and valleys of the hand. But the real trick is to inject it just under the skin in a lump or bolus. Then Dr. Edelson massages the hand to spread the Radiesse evenly. Here's some before and after aging hands. It may take a few injections per hand, but the results are remarkable and are said to last for up to a year. Remember Pat's hands before? Here they are just a few minutes later.
It was totally painless, just a little pinch, and then, you know, you felt nothing. The lidocaine kicked in.
Mm-hmm. So what do you think, though?
I think they're fabulous.
Now, there are other techniques that have been tried on hands, fat injections, collagen injections, but they tended to be kind of lumpy because those materials wouldn't flow into the nooks and crannies on the back of the hand. Plus, they don't last as long. Although different people break down the Radiesse at different rates, this is supposed to last 6, 10, maybe even 12 months before you need another dose of rejuvenation.
You need it every year, really.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's nothing is permanent that
right.
way.
A lot of people love seeing the needle go in here in the studio.
Grow up.
That's what I said.
I mean, come on.
I agree.
It's just it's a tiny little needle, and
exactly.
It's part of, you know, small price to pay for beauty, I guess.
Well, what about the other signs of aging, like the sunspots or, you know?
That's really common, again, because the hands are always out in the open, so they get a lot of sun and sunspots. There are lasers that you can hit with the sunspots, takes away the sunspots. Some people, for that kind of crepey skin, they even do chemical peels
really?
On the back of the hand to rejuvenate the skin that way. So there are a few other things you can do, but for the sort of loss of fat and the veiny, tendony looking kind of thing, you need some kind of filler.
So now it's not just the face we have to worry about, now we have to worry about the hands.
Well, what can I tell you? Or you can just age.
Don't worry about
it.
Gracefully, yeah. It's not happening.
Dr. Max Gomez, thank you.
Is the subcutaneous fat transfer over?
Yes, you can watch now.
The subcutaneous fat.